In the 17th century, Robert Boyle studied the relationship between the pressure and the volume of a gas, systematically and quantitatively. Boyle's experiment. To investigate the pressure-volume relationship of air sample, Boyle used a J-shaped tube. The shorter end of the J-shaped tube was closed or sealed, while the other end was opened to the atmosphere. On the opened end of the tube, he poured mercury at constant temperature. This caused the compression of the air on the closed end of the tube. Initially, the height of mercury is equal in the open and closed parts of the tube because the pressure exerted on the gas by mercury is equal to atmospheric pressure. So, the total pressure of the gas is equal to 1 atmospheric pressure, and its volume is V. If enough mercury is added to the right side, to give a difference in height of 760 millimeters of mercury between the two arms, then the pressure of the gas is 760 millimeter of mercury, that means 1 atmospheric pressure plus 760 millimeter of mercury, which is added to the column. Then the total pressure of the gas is 1520 millimeter of mercury and the volume is half of the total volume of the gas. If an additional 760 millimeters of mercury is added to the column on the right, then the total pressure on the gas increases to 2280 millimeters of mercury, and the volume of the gas decreases to 1/3. Boyle's observation by this experiment. At constant temperature, the greater the force exerted on the trapped air, the smaller the volume of a given amount of a gas. Boyle's law. The pressure of a fixed amount of gas, maintained at constant temperature, is inversely proportional to the volume of the gas. That means, P is inversely proportional to V. So, the product of the pressure and volume of a gas is a constant. When a fixed amount of gas, at constant temperature, changes from pressure PI and volume VI to pressure PF and volume VF, then the product of PI and VI is equal to the product of PF and VF. From the graph we see that the pressure of an ideal gas decreases with an increase in the volume. The curve is hyperbolic in nature. It can also be observed that the curve shifts up with an increase in temperature. Each curve is at a constant temperature, which is called an isotherm. Limitations of Boyle's law. Boyle's law is applicable only to ideal gases. The law holds good only at moderate temperatures and pressures. At low pressures, the particles are farther apart, so these intermolecular forces are very weak, and this law holds well. At moderate to high temperatures, the particles move too fast for the weak intermolecular forces to be attracted by them. The law fails at high pressures and low temperature. At low temperatures and high pressure, the speed of the gas molecules decreases and move closer together. So, under these conditions, a real gas will liquefy. Applications of Boyle's law. Spray painting. Drawing fluid into a syringe. Pump up a bike tire. If you do like my channel, please subscribe, comment, share the videos to your friends and like them.